your hosts, the Dinner Scrum Upwell, it's Van and Kay!
Yes, hello and welcome to Family Fortunes, a show which takes two celebrity families and finds out who's got nose and who's got note. And they pay him. The aim of the game is very, very simple. Two families have to guess the top answers to the surveys we've carried out. Get them right, and they could win up to £30,000 for the charity of their choice. But get them wrong, and they'll hear this. I love it. All right, it's time for two tribes to go to war. Let's meet family number one. See if you can guess who's got the feet farthest under the table in this house.
Hi, Vernon, I'm Christina, and I live here with my dad. These are our dogs. Snoopy, Shadow, Coco, and Lola.
Hi, Vernon, I'm Ian, the estate manager of this manor. Not only does this celebrity live here, but he hosts his own academy.
Well, Vernon, what I can tell you about my dad is he's really, really healthy, and he won't eat carbs after 2 o'clock. And also, this is his favourite room in the house, completely, the kitchen. My dad's a really good cook. He's quite interesting with his food. But when I go outside, I always see the dogs with food like this, which I find a little bit unfair. I bought this for my dad a couple of years ago, just so he wouldn't get homesick, but sadly, he didn't find it funny or amusing because he still gets his English jokes back to front. Before I give too much away, I better go, so I'll see you guys in the night. Bye.
Please welcome, with his family, it's Top Chef John Christophe Novelli. I'm very good, thank you. John Christophe, welcome to the show. It's a pleasure, an absolute pleasure to have you with us. And just quickly, because you're on the show, does that mean that me and my wife get a free meal?
I've got 50 quid if you want.
Oh! All right, John Christophe, where have you brought your family from?
Well, this is my beautiful daughter, Christina.
Hi, Christina.
Hi, Vernon.
Then we have Anthony, my brother, who just arrived from Spain, especially for today.
Hi, Anthony, thanks for flying over.
Hello, Vernon.
Then we have my cousin over there, Vincent.
Hi, Vincent.
Hi, Vernon.
And then we have Ian, who is a very special friend. He's part of the family. He's like a son for me.
Hi, Ian.
Hi, Vernon.
Now, John Christophe, there's one question I've got to ask you before we go any further. OK, let's assume that you've been out on a night out with the lads, OK, and you get in, you're a little bit tipsy. You've had some posh Pinot Grigio or some Chateau de Pinot Grigio? I don't know. Something swanky. Have you ever been tempted to get a can of beans out the cupboard, put them in the microwave with two slices of buttered toast?
Oh, sure, my beans on toast, yeah, absolutely.
All right, with a certain je ne sais quoi?
Un petit peu de je ne sais quoi, oui.
All right, well, tonight is all about charity. Which charity are you going to be playing for?
Well, I've got two charities, if it's possible. There is SOS Children Village, which is based in South Africa, especially this one, and CHESS. It's a children hospice, and it's based just outside Guildford.
Well, we wish you all the very best of luck. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for the Novellis! Now, as you know, Family Fortunes is all about two families going head-to-head, so see if you can guess who's the daddy in this family.
Hi, Vern. How are you? Welcome to our home.
Love and marriage, love and marriage, go together like...
Now, what can I tell you about my lovely husband? He's the king of the catchphrase, the darling of daytime television. The women adore him, and so do I. Will you look at all this junk that he keeps collecting? And they're certainly not as cheap as chips. You know, he loves his food when he's not doing television. I'm very good in the kitchen. Oh, we can't wait to do Family Fortunes. See you soon. Bye.
Yes, we family. It's the Bobby Nelson himself, David Dickinson.
You look at Bobby.
bedazzler, mate.
Well, I was just going to say exactly the same thing to you, David. You look as sharp as a knife. I just want to reassure everyone at home that we have checked that David is a real Dickinson. We bent him over and checked the hallmark. All right, David, where have you brought the family from?
From Cheshire and from Jersey.
Nice. So, please, introduce me to your beautiful family, please, David.
First of all, her indoors, my wife, the lovely Lawn.
Hi, Lawn.
The good-looking one, my brother, Ken.
Hi, Ken.
Hi, everyone. All right.
His wife, Sue.
Hi, Sue.
Hi, David.
And the young one at the end there is my niece, Sarah. Wow.
Hi, Sarah. All right. David, it's all about charity, as we've just heard from Jean-Christophe. Yep. What charity are you going to be playing for tonight?
It is the St. Anne's Hospice, Heal Green, Cheshire.
Excellent. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for the Dickinsons! David, Jean-Christophe, get ready. Let's go down the front. You at home, you can play as well. Let's play Family Fortunes! Jean-Christophe! All right, good luck, David. Good luck, Jean-Christophe. We've surveyed 100 people in all our games. We're looking for the top 7 answers. One hand by the buzzer, one hand behind your back. Name something women usually do better than men. Jean-Christophe.
Love.
Jean-Christophe, the romantic Frenchman, is saying love. It's not there! David!
We are going to say a cooking.
Cooking, all right. Yeah. Name something women usually do better than men. I can't believe you said that in front of one of the world's best chefs. You said cooking, our survey said... It's there! Well done, do you want to play all pass, David?
You want to play all pass?
All right, Jean-Christophe, start conferring with your family. You never know, you might get the chance to steal. No conferring the Dickinson family. Now, Lawn, you make a superb couple.
You.
How long have you been married?
I've not been married.
You see?
37 years.
37 years. Now, we know it's 37 years, to be honest with you, David, because we've got a picture. Take a look at this, ladies and gentlemen. This is when David and Lawn first met! Aww. I've got to say, David. Right, Lawn, back to the game. Name something women usually do better than men.
Kissing.
Kissing. I would beg to differ. All right, Lawn saying kissing. Our survey said... It's not there. Ooh. Ken, what do you think? Something that women usually do better than men.
Shopping.
Shopping. Ken saying shopping, our survey says... Oh, what? Sue, this is to keep you in the game. You need to find 6 answers. If this is wrong, we're going over to the Novellis with a chance to steal. Something women usually do better than men.
I'd say...
Need to rush
cleaning.
It. Cleaning. Sue's saying cleaning. Our survey says... Yeah! Well done. And that noise means that you have won a prize. Take a look at this, Sue.
Well, Sue, we're bringing you a taste of the high life. And you can't get much higher than an exclusive champagne party for 20 of your friends in your very own capsule on the British Airways London Eye.
Sarah, name something women usually do better than men.
Garden.
Gardening.
Yeah, the gardening.
All right, Sue's saying gardening. Our survey says... It's not there. Novellis, you've got a chance to steal. Come on, Ian, let's have your answer. What do you think?
Oh, driving.
Driving. Vincent?
Lying.
Lying. Controversial. Ironing.
Ironing.
Sorry?
Ironing.
Ironing, yeah.
How they present themselves, like cleanliness and stuff.
How they present themselves, cleanliness. Jean-Christophe, what do you think?
I would have to say hygiene.
Right, Jean-Christophe, for the steal, he's saying hygiene. Our survey says... It's not there! Digitrins, you managed to hold on to the point. Well done. This was a tough category. Let's have a look at the missing answers. Number 7 was... Drive. You said that, Anthony?
I am.
All right, the 6th missing answer was... Mole.
About that one.
The fifth answer was multitask. Hey, I'm not having that. I can multitask. I can drink lager and eat peanuts at the same time. And the fourth most popular answer was and finally, number three, everything. Well, for the first round of single money, the Novellis are yet to score, but the Dickinsons, they've got 47. Christina and Lorne, come and join me at the front. Let's play more Family Fortunes. Lorne's Christina, Christina's as well. Yeah. We're looking for the top six answers. One hand by your buzzer, one hand behind your back. Every point is worth a pound. Name someone who's seen you naked. Christina.
My boyfriend.
Your boyfriend. What? Just don't tell him about us. Right. Christina, in front of her father, said her boyfriend. Our survey said... Yes! Top answer! Gonna play off that. Gonna play, okay, we're gonna play. Lorne, back to your family. Start conferring, coming up with some answers. Now, Christina, before
Sorry,
we go on
good.
To you.
I need to ask you a okay. question.
Really?
Are you sure? You have a boyfriend?
I think that's an exclusive. All I'm going to say, Christina, is wait till you get home. Now, Christina, you've got a story to tell us about Jean-Christophe.
Yeah.
He's a bit of a competitive young man, isn't he?
Yeah, sort of.
And it all started way back in school?
Mm-hmm. At my sports day, yeah.
What happened?
Well, it was the father race, you know, when all the dads run. And, well, he wasn't anywhere to be seen. He didn't turn up through the whole thing. And then I just turned, looked, and there he was, the line, like, stretching and, like...
I managed to win, yeah?
Yeah, yeah.
OK, well,
I'm still in shock.
Let's go.
All right, here we go. Anthony, name someone who's seen you naked.
My parents.
Your parents, all right. Anthony is saying his parents. Our survey says... Yes, well done. You made it. Vincent. Someone who's seen you naked?
A statue.
A statue?
Yeah.
Can I just say, Vincent, I hope that you don't run around the Louvre. All right, Vincent's saying a statue. Our survey says...
That's a statue.
What have you been feeding him?
I don't know.
C'est d'accord. Ian. Let's bring it back. Let's get some sanity in the room. Name someone who's seen you naked.
Nurse.
A nurse?
Yeah.
Ian's saying a nurse. Our survey says... Yeah! Well done, got a nurse. And of course, that noise means that you have won a prize. Ian, congratulations. This is coming on with you.
Oh, the beautiful English countryside. And the best way to admire it is when it's rushing towards you at 120 miles per hour. Yes, Ian, we love you so much, we're going to push you out of a plane with this exhilarating tandem skydive.
Am I right in saying that you have never been in an aeroplane?
Never at all, no.
Well, tonight, Ian, you've won the chance to sit in an aeroplane and then someone's going to throw you out to me. Great. Well done.
Brilliant.
Right, Jean-Christophe, name someone who's seen you naked.
It has to be, I don't know, frankly, naked.
Can I rush you?
My mum.
Oh. Mother's already gone, but the time is gone, so you lose a life. Thank you. Christina, name someone who's seen you naked.
My nan.
Your nan. All right, Dickinsons, if it's not up there, you've got the chance to steal. Christina, she's saying her nan. Our survey says... It's not there! Sarah, what do you think?
Ooh, the mirror.
The mirror, nice! The mirror, too.
Sports friends, you want to be
sports
playing.
Sports friends?
Yeah.
Okay, Ken?
Changing
father.
Room.
A father, Lorne?
TV time, so David.
Wait. The TV Times has seen David naked. Is that right?
Yeah,
Well, centrefold, I just had this little teddy bear.
Teddy bear. Whoa, if I was a man, David, I wouldn't say a little teddy bear. I'd say a middle teddy bear. You know what I mean? Big up yourself. Right, so, the TV Times, David, what are you saying?
I'm going to say father.
Father. All right, there are three missing answers. If father is one of them, then the Dickinsons have stolen from the Novellis. The Dickinsons are saying father. Our survey says... it's not there! Well done, Jonathan Scott. You managed to hold on to the point.
You've done nothing.
Exactly, you've done nothing, but you found out that your daughter's got a boyfriend.
Right.
So, well done. OK, let's have a look at the missing answers, shall we? OK, in sixth place... window cleaner. In fifth place, a baby. And the third most popular answer we were looking for was the midwife.
Yeah.
The midwife. Well, after that, the Dickinsons have got 47 and the Novellis have got 86. It's time to take a break now. Family Fortunes, where we're about to find out who gets the charity cash and who is the charity case. It's the Novelli family versus the Dickinson family. All right, good luck to both teams. Anthony and Ken, come and join me at the front and let's play more Family Fortunes. Anthony, Ken, Anthony. Every point is worth a pound. One hand by your buzzer, one hand behind your back. We've surveyed 100 people. We're looking for the top seven answers. Name something you squeeze. Anthony.
Lemon.
A lemon? You said it's so sexy.
Limon.
All right, Anthony's saying a limon. Our survey says... yes! Top answer. Got to play our pass.
Please.
All right, we're going to play. Ken, back to the Dickinson family. Start coming up with some answers. You might get the chance to steal. Vincent, this is going to be good. Name something you squeeze. Need an answer?
No.
Quick. Oh!
Orange.
Time's gone, I'm afraid. You lose a life. I'm sorry. We need six more answers. All right, Ian, name something that you squeeze.
A sponge.
A sponge. All right, Ian's saying a sponge. Our survey says... yes, it's fair. Well done. Six more popular answers. We need five more. You've lost one life. You've got two lives left. Jean-Christophe.
Oranges.
Oranges. Jean-Christophe is saying oranges. Our survey says... yes, well done. Christina. What? Don't know. Conferring, Jean-Christophe. Saw you there. You might have to spank your bum-bum. Christina, name something you squeeze. I'll give you a tip. Don't say your boyfriend.
OK. A teddy bear.
A teddy bear?
Oh,
yeah.
Christina's saying a teddy bear. Our survey says... it's not there. Unlucky. Anthony, name something you squeeze.
Lime.
Lime. I think we're going through the citrus fruits tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Anthony's saying a lime. Our survey says... oh, it's not there! Dickinson, you got the chance to steal. Sarah, what do you think?
Cheeks.
Oh, cheeks! I said cheeks. Squeeze your cheeks. Sue?
Somebody's bottom.
Someone's bum-bum. Ken?
Spot.
A spot? Mom?
Nose.
Squeeze your nose. David?
I'm going to go with squeeze someone's bum-bum or squeeze your partner.
Which one? Bum-bum or partner?
Bum-bum.
All right, we'll go with bum-bum. For the steal, the Dickinson family are saying squeeze your bum to steal from the Novellis. Our survey says... yay! Well done, David. Well done, the Dickinsons. Congratulations. All right, three missing answers. The seventh most popular answer was... balls. Stress balls. Stress balls. Stress balls, Christina. Don't know what you were thinking, Lauren. Hey! Look at the time, it's only early evening. Right, the fifth most popular answer was... toothpaste. And we've been surveying the zoo again. All right, and the last missing answer, the second most popular answer we were looking for was... spots, you said spots, well done. All right, after that, the Novelli family have got 86 points and the Dickinsons are in the lead just with 99. All right, Vincent, Sue, come and join me down the front. Let's double all the points. It's time for double money. Vincent, Sue, you've got everything to play for, both teams. All the points now are worth twice the prize. So good luck. Vincent, are you all right?
Yeah, I'm all right.
The man that ran naked in front of a load of statues. We're looking for the top four answers. We've surveyed 100 people. Name a reason why a woman might marry an ugly man. You were too quick off the mark first. What's your answer?
Money.
I doubt she's speaking from experience. Sue saying money! Top answer!
Well done, Sue's on the playoff pass.
All right, we're going to play Vincent back to your family. Start conferring. Dickinson's no conferring, please. Well done, Sue. Sarah, name a reason why a woman might marry an ugly man.
Because they're funny. Sense of humour.
Because they've got a sense of humour. Sue's saying sense of humour. Our survey says... it's not there. You've got two lives left. We're only looking for three answers. David, what do you think? Need to rush you. Oh, time's up. And Sarah did say, thank you. And Sarah did say, being funny. All right, Lorne, name a reason why a woman might marry an ugly man.
Because she loves him.
Good old-fashioned love. Good old-fashioned love. All right, Lorne is saying love. Our survey says... yay! Well done, Lorne. And, of course, as you know, by now, that noise means you've won a prize. Tonight, you're going home with this.
Lorne, prepare yourself for sun, sea, glitz and gold. You can shop till you drop or enjoy a feast with belly dancing in this millionaire's paradise. It's a weekend trip for two to Dubai.
Are you going back? You can top up your tongue. All right. Ken, name a reason why a woman might marry an ugly man.
Oh, dear. Why are you looking at me?
Don't give me sympathy.
Security.
Security.
Yes, very good.
Ken saying security, our survey says... oh, it's not there. Unlucky. The advantage, you've got the chance to steal. Ian, what are you thinking?
Well endowed.
Vincent?
His car.
His car, Anthony?
Because she's ugly or so?
Because she's ugly or so?
famous.
Because they're famous. Jean-Christophe?
Personality.
Personality, but yeah. You're the head of the family. Which answer are you going to go for?
I think I'd go for the car, actually.
The car, because they've got a nice car? All right, for the steal, the Novelli family are saying because they've got a nice car. Our survey says... it's not there! Well done, the Dickinson. Managed to hold on to those points once more. Right then, the missing answers we were looking for. Number four was... nice personality. You said that. And number three was... she's ugly too! You said that! We had them both. After that, the Novellis have got 86, but in the lead with 283, it's the Dickinson! Ian and Sarah, come and join me up the front, let's play more. Double money! Ian, Sarah, Sarah, Ian.
Hi. Nice to meet you.
Ian, are you single?
I am indeed.
Sarah, are you single?
I am.
We'll have a drink in the green room after. I need a new hat. Right, we've surveyed 100 people, looking for the top three answers. Name a food that gives you wind. Ian.
Onions.
Onions. From experience. Ian saying onions, our survey says... it's not there, what do you think?
Beans.
Sarah saying beans. Beans, beans, they're good for your heart. The more you eat, our survey says... yes! Yeah. Well done. Gotta play our part. David, name a food that does give you wind.
Peas.
Peas. Peas. David's saying peas. Our survey says... no word. Hey, I'll take it. tell you what, Lorne, after tonight, you're coming home with me. Lorne, name a food that gives you wind. Not that a lady would get wind.
No. Fibre.
Fibre? Any kind of fibre in particular?
Bran.
Bran. All right, Lorne is saying bran. Our survey says it's not there. Novellis, get ready. Start conferring. You could get the chance to steal. Ken, a food that gives you wind.
Sprouts.
Sprouts.
They're saying yes.
Ken is saying sprouts. Our survey says
yes.
Well done. Well done. All right, Sue, what do you think? A food that gives you wind.
Cabbage.
Cabbage. Is it there? It's not there, Novellis! You got the chance to steal. Ian, what do you think?
Curry.
Curry. Vincent?
Pass.
Pass. Anthony?
Chickpeas.
Chickpeas. Christina?
Curry.
Curry. Now, Jean-Christophe?
I would say garlic.
Garlic? But you're the head of the family?
No, what? I'm going to say...
I'll say curry.
I would say curry.
Curry. OK. For the steal, from the Dickinsons, the Novellis are saying curry. Our survey says... yes! After that final round, I can tell you that the Novellis have scored 270, but in the lead and taking victory tonight, it's the Dickinsons with 283! It was too little, too late, I'm afraid. You did get the final missing answer, but unfortunately, it's not taken you on to victory. But never mind, Vincent, that is an answer that will stay in my mind for a long, long time. Someone who's seen you naked, a statue. You don't go away empty-handed, because what we've done, we've taken your score of 270. We're going to triple that. So tonight, Jean-Christophe, you're walking away with £810 for charity. Plus, Ian, you won the skydiving trip as well. So, ladies and gentlemen, give them a massive round of applause. So, after the break, David and the Dickinsons will be playing in our big money final. Who's he going to choose? We'll find out after the break. Welcome back to Family Fortunes. Now, before the break, we saw the Dickinson family win the main game, which means it's time for two of the family to play in our big money final. Now then, David, you are the head of the family. Who are you going to take to the hotspot?
Young Sarah.
It's a good choice. A good choice. All right, Sarah, David, come and join me down the front. Let's play for big money. All right, Sarah, David. The object of this is very, very simple. Between you, you need to score 200 points. If you do that, we'll give you £10,000 for charity. If, however, you get all top five answers between you, we'll throw in another 20 grand, which means tonight you could walk away with £30,000 for the charity of your choice. Now, David, you're going to go first. So if you'd like to scoot off to our soundproof booth, I know you're a big fan of the Bay City Rollers. We've not got any of that. We've got some Metallica for you and some more thrash metal. So off you go.
OK, thank you.
All right, Sarah?
Yes.
I'm going to ask you five questions. You've got 15 seconds. If you can't think of an answer, just say pass and we'll come to it at the end. All right?
Yeah.
Wish you all the very best of luck.
I need it.
Can we have 15 seconds on the clock? Name a season of the year.
Summer.
Name a green vegetable.
Run of beans.
Name a subject people gossip about.
Relationships.
Name something you might do before a long car journey.
It's the toilet.
Name a popular type of gambling.
Racing, horse racing.
Well done. Oh my God. Yeah.
Yeah.
When you're on the hot spot. Yeah. Well done, you were very quick with your answers, so that's always a good sign. Let's turn around and have a look at the board.
Oh my God.
Name a season of the year. You said summer. Our survey said 35. Well done. Name a green vegetable.
Think of one.
You said. Okay, not an answer. Run of beans. Our survey said 11. We got 46. You're going to be able to get over 100.
Yeah.
Name a subject people gossip about. You said relationships. Our survey said 21. We got 67. you got 33 now in the last two answers, we'd be
up to 100.
It's good. Name something you might do before a long car journey. You said, go to the loo. Our survey said, 41. Well done. Brilliant start. You got 108. That puts David in good stead. Right, name a popular type of gambling. You said, racing. Our survey said, 34. Wow. Well done. You scored 142. Go back to your family. Let's clear the board and let's welcome back David Dickinson. All right, David, I can tell you that Sarah scored 142.
Clever clogs. Blimey.
Which means you need to get 58 to guarantee yourself 10 grand for your charity.
OK.
I'm going to ask you the same five questions. If you can't think of an answer, just say pass. We'll come back to it at the end. If you give me an answer that Sarah's already given me, you'll hear this noise. I'll ask you for another answer. I'm going to give you an extra 5 seconds, so we're going to give you 20 seconds.
Right.
All right. Can we remind the viewers at home of the answers? Can we have 20 seconds on the clock? Good luck, David.
Thank you.
Name a season of the year.
Summer.
Another one.
Winter.
Name a green vegetable.
Cabbage.
Name a subject people gossip about.
Romance.
Another one. Come on.
Pass.
Name something you might do before a long journey.
Sleep.
You were just in time. You were just on the buzzer, but we didn't get time to get to the fifth question.
Right.
All right, David. But remember, we only need 58.
Okay.
Okay. So let's turn around, have a look at the board. There are Sarah's answers. Good luck. Name a season of the year. You said winter. Our survey said 26. Was summer a top answer? Yeah. Well done. Well done. Name a green vegetable. You said cabbage. Our survey said 21. We've got 189. We need 11 for £10,000.
Oh.
Cabbage scored 21. Was it a top answer? No. Unlucky. I can tell you that peas was the top answer.
Green peas.
So we can't get the £30,000. However, if we score 11 or more now, then we'll get £10,000. Name a subject people gossip about. You passed. I can tell you that gossiping about the neighbours was a top answer.
Yeah.
Name something you might do before a long car journey. You said sleep. Now, this answer needs to be 11 or more for £10,000 because you didn't give me an answer on the final question. You said sleep. For 10 grand, our survey said... Yeah! Well done. Well done, Sarah. Give me a kiss. Well done, David. And the Dickinsons. Congratulations.
Thank you very much indeed.
You've won £10,000 for the charity of your choice. And, of course, you've won the champagne trip on the London Eye. And you've also won that trip loan to Dubai.
Fantastic.
For the weekend.
Fantastic.
They've been great sport, ladies and gentlemen. Give them a massive round of applause, the Dickinson family. Thanks to both our families. We'll see you next time on Family Fortunes. Good night.
There's cash, there's prizes, but there's hot spots too. Steer clear. It's Strike It Lucky in just a mo. Then just who is the body? That mysterious figure who always beats the cube. No idea, but I've not seen Pam Ayres for a bit. The game commences at 4:00.